Now let's consider the spherical coordinate system. Again, we're going to look for our elemental units of line, surface, and volume. So let's consider each of the elements that make up this little cubical sort of piece of sphere. This element right here is going to have a length dr. This distance right there, we can see that's varying with d theta, but it's not a distance all by itself. In fact, it's going to be r times d theta. Down here on the bottom, this piece varies with d phi, but it's not a distance all by itself. In fact, it is r sine of theta d phi. So these are our three elements of distance. In the r direction, it varies with dr. In the theta direction, it varies with r d phi. And in the phi direction, it varies with r sine of theta d phi. Now we can use each of these to help define the surface that we would be looking at. So if, for instance, we wanted to look at this front surface, we would poke a hole in it, and which direction would the water come out? It would come out radially. It would come out in the r direction. So the surface in the r direction is going to be made up of these two pieces. It's going to be made up of r sine of theta, and then it's going to be made up of r d theta. So the two r's go together to give me an r squared. I have a sine of theta d phi. What if I poked this thing up here on the top? Let's poke it on the bottom. Because if I poke it on the bottom, I'm going to be going in the phi direction. So right here, that's the piece I'm going to be getting. Now what's the size of that bottom? The bottom is going to be made up of r sine of theta times dr. So here it is right here. And then this phi one is, if I poked it on the back side, it would give me a phi-directed squirt of water, which would have the magnet, which would have the surface area of r dr d theta. The dv part, the volume part, is going to be the multiplication of all three of these pieces, as you can see right here.